Now that we have all of our files organized outside of the program, let's go ahead and open up Premiere and let's talk about the Premiere Pro interface. I am always very tempted when learning a new program to skip through the interface tutorial because I'm like, just take me to something that is interesting. But trust me, the more you guys learn the interface of Premiere, the more comfortable you are with the names of the different tabs that we're going to be accessing throughout the semester, the better editors you will become. So let's take some time, let's explore Premiere Pro. Go ahead and get Premiere Pro open. You'll be greeted with the home screen that gives you an option to make a new project or open an existing project. Now you see that I have a list of projects that I've been working on down here for the class. You guys, if this is the first time you've opened Premiere, you won't see anything listed there, and that's okay. We're going to go ahead and create a brand new project. So click on New Project. This takes you to the New Project dialog box where we can name our project and then choose where to save our project. I'm going to go ahead and name this project in all caps, Sample Project. And then guess where I'm going to save this? Yeah, in our new file structure we just made. So under the Location tab, click on Browse, and then go to the folder that we made earlier called Sample Project, and then navigate to your project folder and select it. Then click Select Folder. So now our Premiere Pro project file will exist inside of our project folder in our folder structure. Now we have three tabs down here, one called General, one called Scratch Disks, and one called Ingest Settings. General we'll just keep as standard, though it does give us the option of using our GPU or our graphics card if you guys have maybe like a gaming PC or a MacBook Pro with a good graphics card. GPU acceleration is a good addition. Everything else we can keep the same. Scratch disks are very important though. Let's click on the Scratch Disks tab. Think of this as the short-term memory of Premiere. Every time you click on something or change a setting, Premiere has to kind of memorize that or remember it, and it does so in a very specific folder. Now the issue here is that scratch disks can sometimes get unwieldy and rather large, so we want to make sure that we save our scratch disks to a folder or a hard drive that has enough space to cope. I'm going to keep mine in my sample project, but it's totally okay for you guys to click Browse and navigate to a totally different hard drive for your scratch disks. In my normal setup, I have a hard drive dedicated to scratch disks alone. Assuming we'll keep these same as project, I'm going to go over to Ingest Settings. The Ingest Settings in Premiere is a newer tab. We're not going to mess with these, but it is kind of a way to automatically bring in files into your project. And to create proxies, but again, we're not going to worry about any of that, so let's just go back to General. And with all of our settings set, our project named, our project file saved in a specific folder, let's go ahead and click OK. And now, welcome to Premiere. Now, just like every other Adobe program, Premiere is built out in panels. And as you guys click around, you'll notice that these panels will highlight. Unlike Photoshop or even After Effects, Premiere does not have that many default panels. In fact, there's really only six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and our audio meters make 6. Now let's talk about what these individual panels actually mean. Now at the very top of the program, we have our menu bar. This is where we would save a project, create a new project, make a new sequence, reorganize our workspaces, and we'll get to each of these different items as we navigate Premiere. But let's talk about first our project panel. Now our project panel, which consists of these different tabs here, is where we're going to be importing our media. Now it says import media to start, but we're going to worry about importing in the next lesson. For now, we're worried about just the interface, but the project panel is where all of your media will exist, so you can drag and drop it into your timeline panel. Now your timeline panel does not have a visible timeline in it because we haven't created a sequence. And I'll talk about sequences in the next lesson too as we get started with editing, but your timeline panel is where the editing will actually take place. Next to that, we have our toolbar, with just a few tools that we'll learn as we go. Up top, we have our source panel. Our source panel will come alive once we start to import things. And to the right, we have our program panel. And this program panel is where we're gonna watch what we're editing. Now you may be asking, well, those are the panels, but what about all these different tabs? They're very important, but not to get started. So to think through what we'd have to do to get started, we'd have to import some media in the project panel, get it into a timeline to start editing, and be able to view it so we can see what it is we're changing. So now that we've talked about the panels, let's talk about how we can move them and reorganize them. Let's look up top here in these different workspaces. Now these workspaces, if you click on them, they change the look of Premiere. So based on what part of production you're working in, you have a layout that favors that particular process. Now, I will always be working in the editing tab inside of Premiere. It is the default tab, and honestly, I don't want you guys to have to learn 6 different interfaces of Premiere. So I will always be working in the editing workspace. But let's say you want to make your own workspace. For example, I'm working on a 38-inch ultra-wide monitor, and so I created an ultra-wide preset. That way it spreads Premiere across my entire monitor. Maybe you're working on 2 or 3 monitors, or maybe you just want to reorganize and put a panel somewhere different. You do this by dragging and dropping the different panels. For example, if I wanted my effects tab down here to be a new panel, I would just click and drag the effects tab to these different areas. And you can see that I can now drag and drop this in any of these different areas. Let's say I want it right here. I let go. That now brings the entire tab up here, making a brand new panel. And we can reorganize the entirety of Premiere to be exactly how we would want it. You could even close out panels if you don't want them by clicking on the 3 little lines, the hamburger icon as Adobe calls them. You can click close panel. Start closing things, start messing everything up. So now that you've ruined Premiere and you're panicking because now you think, oh no, I've ruined the program, what do I do now? I want to show you how to reset your workspace to be exactly as it was when you opened it. Go up to Window in the menu bar, come down to Workspaces, and notice we're still in editing because we've changed the editing layout. We want to reset this to the saved layout. Or if you like what you've done, you can hit save as new workspace. But I'm going to go ahead and reset this. Ah, there it is, just as we found it when we opened it. So feel free to reorganize your layout inside of Premiere, but know that I will always be working in the editing tab in the default layout. So those are the panels inside of Premiere, and that's how we create our own workspaces, reset workspaces, and understand the basic layout.